Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to another special session of Tech Check. And as always, we're bringing you interesting, young, new things from Pakistan. Today, we're very fortunate to have with us Meenah Tariq, the general partner at Karavan Ventures in Pakistan. I'll let Meenah introduce herself and tell us a little more about what they're doing in Pakistan. Meenah, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having me and for a very nice introduction.
Well, Meenah, it's a pleasure. I know we've been trying to do this for a little while. We're always trying to find interesting people doing interesting things in the Pakistan tech ecosystem. And with that, let's dive right in. So please tell us a little more about you. Tell us a little more about Karavan.
Sure. So hello, everybody. My name is Meenah Tariq. I've been working in the Pakistan entrepreneurship space for a while now, and I've kind of sat on all sides of the table by this point in time. The latest one, the latest side that I've kind of been at now for the past, I think 2 years at this point, is the venture capital investment side. I started off by working in an accelerator program. I was running the I2I accelerator program in Pakistan for a few years with our CEO, Kulsoom, and did that for a bit, worked with startups and entrepreneurs of all sorts, working, you know, in the grassroots, from the startups angle. Then I shifted over to the development sector side, which is a pretty big aspect of the entrepreneurship ecosystem in Pakistan, because that's where a lot of the money is coming in to do a lot of development work to build the ecosystem. So I've been working with the USAID, I've been working with the World Bank in designing and deploying programs to do with entrepreneurship and to support entrepreneurs. And like I said, now I've come to the VC side of things. So understanding from the lens of the investor, what makes sense and what doesn't make sense and how to grow the ecosystem from that side. So I joined Karavan, like I said, a little while ago, and Karavan is a small VC fund focusing on Pakistan. We've been investing partner capital. My two partners are based out of the Middle East. We've been investing partner capital. We've done a very large number of deals in Pakistan, comparative to where the landscape is. So we've done 8 deals so far, 5 of which we did in COVID year during the pandemic, all of last year. So right. it's been an interesting journey.
Awesome. Oh, that's very cool. And it's great. You know, again, what we're trying to do here at TechCheck is obviously highlight a lot of people who are undertaking these efforts. They're often doing them kind of in a vacuum. So we want to make sure people know about what you're doing and how it's being done. And so with that, just, you know, kind of understanding more, can you talk a little more about some of the ventures you've invested in? Maybe
sure.
Some favorites?
And yeah, absolutely. And it's hard to choose favorites, right? Because they kind of become like your babies. So it's sure. Almost being asked to choose a favorite child. And even if you do have a favorite child, you never ever admit to having a favorite child. I think that's the sure. Rule number one of the game.
Sure.
Our portfolio is also on our website. We've done 8 investments so far. So we've done Eid Mubarak, which is a delivery business. We did Mocha Online, which is on-demand domestic help. We did an edtech called Queno. We did all natural organic beauty, Conatural. We did a hospitality startup, again, in the middle of a pandemic, called Roomy. We've done grocery delivery, which is grocer. We've done B2B retail, which is Tajir. So it's an interesting mix. There's Baby Planet, which is mother and child products, e-commerce. So right. It's an interesting mix. And it's hard to choose your favorite. I think you end up loving all of them so much because you get really, you go quite deep when you're researching and doing your due diligence. And you only invest when you really do love them, when you love the problem and you love the solution. That's when you really invest. And of course, when you love the founders, that's when you really invest.
Sure, sure. Well, that's good. Good to know that you've, and it's interesting because I've heard of a few of those. They're a little more active on the scene. As you may know, Queno was with us. I think I've heard of Eat the Mubarak and Tajir. So that's good. That's great. Well, good. There's some prolific folks that you're already starting to work with. Well, with that, you know, and as you know, we keep these fairly short and try not to keep people on too long. I want to get to the bottom line for the diaspora. What can we do to help?
I think there's quite a lot that the diaspora can do to help. And part of it is, so there's two things. There's being or becoming technical mentors for these startups. If you hear of a startup, or if you see a startup, or you hear of a business or an entrepreneur where you think you can add value, where your experience can add value, where your advice can add value, it is really critical that we start to get more and more technical and, you know, industry-specific mentors and experts to come back to Pakistan and start giving back in terms of that knowledge transfer that needs to happen. A lot of the programming that's still happening in Pakistan is very general. There's a lot of generalists giving advice and becoming mentors, myself included. And what we really need is those technical experts to come in. So there's that. And of course, we really need more and more angel investors as well. So if you're somebody who's interested in startups from the investing perspective, we have something called Karavan Co-Invest, which is essentially a very large network of individuals and organizations who are interested in investing in Pakistan and don't have the time or the capacity to come and do their own due diligence and would like to get access to deal flow. And so they get in touch and, you know, we have conversations and we've created and curated this network, and then we bring them into deals with ourselves. And the reason we're doing that is because we understand that to make a, you know, to create a billion-dollar company, you need X millions of dollars of company to go in, X millions of dollars to go into that company before that company can grow to become a unicorn. And that money is still missing in Pakistan. So we all talk about, you know, not seeing a big exit, or what is the best story that's come out of Pakistan. Exits and, you know, beautiful, fantastic entrepreneurial stories of success need money. All of them need injections of capital. And I think that's where the diaspora expertise, so smart capital, right? Capital that comes in with technical knowledge, with knowledge of industry and transfer of that expertise. I think that's what's required.
Awesome. No, that's great. Yeah, it's a very common theme. And hopefully, even we as TechCheck will be starting to help in ways like that. So you'll be hearing about that in subsequent episodes. So, but with that, I do want to thank you very much for your time. We're coming to an end for our episode today. Thank you again for joining us, Meenah.
Thank you for having me. Take care.
You too. And to our audience out there, thank you very much, as always, for tuning in. As you can see, we continue to bring you new, unique, different stories, very different perspectives in some cases. But please continue to like, share, follow. We really need your support. And with that, I say, Allah Hafiz.